Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today, we are going to have a walkthrough on how to do your devotionals. You know, devotionals are very important in your spiritual life, spiritual health. But I feel like I have to be honest with you guys. Devotionals require discipline. You have to really be intentional about planning your own method or planning your own time or basically your routine. One method that is very popular actually is the SOAP method. It's not particularly the method that I'm using because I think individually we have our own set of preferences when we do our quiet time. However, today we are going to tackle more on the SOAP method because it's very easy and it's very practical. So, syempre, you have to set up the things that you're going to need for your devotionals. First and foremost is, syempre, your Bible, highlighters or pens, and then your journal. You may or may not keep your cell phone with you in case you want to check out some commentaries or things that you need to understand in the Bible, words that you need to know or words that you need to understand. But for me, I try to really set it aside kasi pag may nakita ako notification dyan, talagang babasahin ko yan. So, I just put it aside somewhere that I can't reach it. And then I just focus on my Bible and my quiet time. For the SOAP method, S-O-A-P, S stands for scriptures. That means that you have to take note of the scripture that you are reading. In my personal devotion right now, I am currently in 2 Chronicles 14. Yeah, I just finished 15 last night. But what I'm gonna be using as an example for today is from 2 Chronicles 10. I wrote something that really struck me in this chapter. If you're the type that does the journal, I did the journal before, but I found it really practical to just have post-it notes, but I still use my journal for sermon notes or just writing here everything that God has put in my heart. O stands for observation. What did you see in the scripture? What are the words that are repeating? That's very important. What is the main verse that really struck you the most? Or what are the questions that are in your mind? Why did this person do this? So in 2 Chronicles chapter 10, so my observations would be that Rehoboam did not follow the advice of the elder. He instead followed the advice of some young men who he grew up with. Because of that, the kingdom of Israel was divided. So next is A for application. Here you should be asking yourself, what is God telling me through this scripture? How can I apply what God is telling me in my own life? And how do I make these changes? My attention was immediately focused on the decision of Rehoboam not taking the advice of the elder. And how do I apply this in my life? You could say that before making a major decision, like the course you're taking in college, the career that you're choosing for yourself, the person that you're gonna be in a relationship with, pretty much the decisions that would really affect your future. What changes do I have to make? I will have to really humble myself before my leaders, before my parents, and really take their advices into consideration. And before asking my friends what they think about this one, I will have to ask my parents first and then my leaders. And then after that is P for prayer. Now this is the moment that you completely be honest with God. What are the sins that you saw in yourself that you realize by reading the scripture? Now that is how you do the SOAP method. Again, that's S for scripture, O for observation, A for application, and P for prayer. There is no easy way to do your devotionals. There is no faster way to do it. There are still a lot of methods for you to do your own devotionals, and you can even create your own. Next time, I will be sharing with you guys another method, which is I learned in our Bible training classes in my church, which is another very practical way for you to do your devotionals, and it has helped me a lot in the past year. And through it, I was able to develop my own way of doing my devotionals. I will be sharing that with you guys on the next vlog, so watch out for that. That's it for today. I hope that you guys learned, and I hope that this stirs your desire to learn more of God's Word and to really go deeper in your faith. Always take in mind that there is no timeline for everything. You can take your time, you can adjust everything that you've learned and gather everything that you have been taught in your church, in your family, your small group, or in the vlogs that you've been watching. So yeah, thank you for being with me today. See you guys on the next vlog. And don't forget, be kind and stay kind to one another. Bye!